Yes, there is a trust deficit between the police and the public, if I put it that way. An accountability commission is a welcome step because, you see, accountability must be inculcated if possible and must be enforced if necessary. While everyone agreed, you see, that accountability primarily must come from within, and the Police Act, Assam Police Act 2007, and even the earlier Police Act of 1861, which we are very fond of calling colonial and outdated and all, even that has factored into it the concept of accountability, because the role of the senior police officers, the law, the reward and punishment systems, including jailing people, all these things are inbuilt into the laws which govern the Police Act, the CRPC, the manuals, the guidelines, the circulars. So accountability is inbuilt, and to a great extent it is from within. But yes, despite that, if there are breaches of accountability and serious breaches of accountability affecting the public at large, I think the Accountability Commission must and should play. Change needs change management.
Right.
You see, the stakeholders have to be managed. And you have to, as I was very clear, that the Police Accountability Commission is a product of the Supreme Court directive. The Supreme Court has given a comprehensive directive. It's not the only directive. And they are all seamlessly integrated. They are like a combo pack, to use that fast food concept and other things. So they can be strengthened together. You can't strengthen one and not others, or you can't strengthen one at the cost of another. So this means like IOs, the investigation. There is a need to have IOs exclusively for investigation in crime-prone areas and in specialized investigation areas. See, in many cases, some crimes are of a traditional nature, simple to handle. Today, we are encountering increasingly large number of crimes which need a specialized domain knowledge of that field, including financial investigations, including cyber investigations. Large number of crimes are taking place on the cyberspace today. And a large number of conventional crimes are also being committed using the cyberspace. So you need capacity, you need people who can handle what tech savvy to handle all those things. So unless you have enough number of investigators, you train, retrain and re-retrain them, because again it is a changing, evolving concept. It will be difficult to fulfill the aspirations of the people. If you want to come up to the expectations of the people, you need the numbers, you need quality investigation, and you need proper attitudes, sensitive attitudes and healthy relationships with the public. Is to look into all their recommendations and honestly get back to them. What can be done? What cannot be done? What cannot be done now? Because after all, everything needs resources. If you put things into perspective, like it is a change, I assume. And change management had to look into the people, the processes, the technology, the resources. And there could be difference in perceptions. But these differences will have to be bridged rather than accentuated.